you are removed from the service because of being unable to convincingly explain to the vetting panel and therefore the commission the sources of your income which was accumulating in your accounts. And secondly, you were not able to tell us how you are able to afford your daily expenses without withdrawing any money from your accounts.
Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today I am bringing you something that myself, when I think about it, I don't know how to understand. It's difficult to understand because it's about a Kenyan police officer, a senior police officer who has been police service for over 20 years. He has been in the service for over 20 years, and since he started receiving salary from the government as a police officer, he has never ever touched his salary for over 20 years. And I think there was an inquiry. I don't know how they got to know about it, but there was an inquiry that was set, like a commission of inquiry, sorry, a commission of inquiry that was set up to investigate some issues within the police service, I think, because some of the people that were on the board, most of them were police officers. So they were asking, how did this man, or how has he been surviving without withdrawing from his account, like his money, his salary that has been given to him every month for over 20 years? Trust me, myself, when I hear this, it's, I don't know. Let's go and watch this video. Please don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe and share.
A senior police officer was today tasked to explain his source of income and why he had never made withdrawals from three bank accounts with millions of shillings since 1999. The National Police Service Commission chairman, Johnston Kavaludi, was particularly interested to know how he has been surviving with no withdrawals from his bank accounts, yet he had financial obligations as a family man and father of three. Joshua Aseto, who had been dismissed last year, was appearing for fresh vetting after the commission failed to get satisfactory answers in the initial exercise.
You are removed from the service because of being unable to convincingly explain to the vetting panel and therefore the commission the sources of your income which was accumulating in your accounts. And secondly, you were not able to tell us how you are able to afford your daily expenses without withdrawing any money from your accounts. So we give you this chance to explain those two facets.
How I meet my daily needs. I'm a 16 years diabetic person, and when I attended diabetic seminars or workshop, I was given a mustard plate. So that any ugali that I take should not be more than that plate I've been given. The vegetables can be as much as I can afford. So my diet is on protein, vegetables, and leguminous crops. So out of my 28 years of service, I've had 16 years of diabetic on method food. That has made my lifestyle to be very simple, thin, lean, simple, thin, lean, and mean. I've not known extravagant lifestyle. I've not known less.
In one of the bank account details tabled before the vetting panel, the officer, who was accompanied by his lawyer, Abbas Esmel, has 1.4 million shillings with no penny withdrawn since 1999 when it was deposited.
So, police headquarters, from 20th November 2014 up to date, I've not been withdrawing my salary. Because when I need food, I tell my wife to send me food through Transline, Easy Coach. I come from Kosele, so my wife, to Yugi, where we have an East Coach office, is Transatlantic. She sends me food. She sends me food, fish and my millet or sorghum nini, unga. I have in personal passion in fixed deposit. I raised money from our family sources, like family so business. I retrieved 300,000 from rice growings at Aero irrigation scheme savings. I raised 415,000. Developed rental plot savings. I raised 250,000. And also we had saved 30 bags of maize because I have two plots. We have two sambas at home, which my wife is farming. Every year come, every year out. So I sold the 30 bags of maize at 250,000 and raised 75,000. I bought a crossbreed from Kisi because I come from Mwabe County and neighbors Kisi. I'd bought some cows which had given birth to half breed bulls. So I sold three crossbreed bulls, and got.
At one time, his lawyer wanted to present his client, resulting in exchanges with the commissioner, who made it clear that it was an administrative process which required the individual police officer.
So, watching this and listening to the inquiry that has been made, what do you have to, and listening to his explanation, the explanation that he has given, what do you think? Because, Charlie, it's still some way, be like, as a, it's still some way, you know, this thing. Do you think it is possible? You know, sometimes, you know, police officers in Africa in general are tagged with being corrupt, and they take bribe and all that. So perhaps, I'm sure the commission is trying to know whether he has been getting some money aside the service, and perhaps, I don't know their rules and their laws and all those stuff, but maybe that's what they are trying to get out of him, that perhaps he had a side hustle, or he was taking bribe, or he was, because they don't understand, for over 20 years, how can you not be withdrawing from your account? He has three kids, and he was saying he has given some money, or he has set up his wife and his wife into farming, so the business is doing well, that's why. So for me, my question is, who pays the school fees? Or the children are not going to school. Or if they are going to school, who pays their fees? Where does that money come from? Does that money also come from the wife? You know, these are questions that sometimes, I don't know. It could also be that whatever he's saying is true, because Charlie, some people can sacrifice for the whole family to be free. Right now, he's a billionaire, because someone who has been paid for over 20 years and he has not touched that money. He's a billionaire or a millionaire now, and the family will never lack anything for the rest of their lives. So for me, I think it's a good thing. It's a good sacrifice that perhaps, if it is true, he has done. And if it is not true, then how was he able to do this? Charlie, let me know what you think in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.